Good morning, children. I hope all are safe and fine at home. Today we are going to start about the abiotic resources part 2. In the last part, we have studied about the abiotic resources and land resources. In this topic, in this part 1, we are going to study about the factors affecting land use pattern, usefulness of the land resources, land degradation, and conservation of the land resources. Before starting this part 2, let us have a recapitulation of the last part. Yes, in the last part we have studied about the land resources. Land resources refers to the shape, form and nature of the land surface. Almost all the activities are associated with the land resources. They provide shelter to both the living organisms and non-living substances. The land resources of the earth contain lofty mountains, flat plains, high plateaus, islands, etc. As a natural resource, they provide all the essential products for satisfying human needs. Along with this, we have studied about the land use. Land use simply means how we use our land. We use land for several activities such as agriculture, grazing, industry, transport, and settlement purposes. All of these are land use type. Land use can change with the time because our requirements and ability to utilize various resources also gets changed. Earlier, Earth was in a natural form, full of forest, desert, rivers, lakes and grasslands only. As it was humanized, man started using land to satisfy his various needs. First, he started agriculture. Then he made settled homes, domesticated animals and got civilized. Later on, mining and industry also followed. As technology evolved, not only requirements for the more resources arose, but their availability and utility also increased. Today, man is using land for new purposes like for dumping waste, for testing nuclear weapons, for entertainment and recreation, etc. Thus, land use never remains the same. It is an ever-changing and evolving process. Land use is determined by the physical factors such as mountain, river, desert, topography, etc. So let's start the factors affecting the land use pattern. The land use pattern is not same everywhere in the world, but highly uneven. This uneven land use pattern is mainly influenced by the following factors, like climate, topography, type of soil, available water, minerals, technology, and human resource. So let's start the factors one by one. First is climate. Land use pattern of any place is directly or indirectly influenced by the climatic conditions. Climate is very harsh in the polar and equatorial regions. Thus, these areas are not suitable for the croplands and the pastures. Tiny shrubs and thick forests are found in these areas, whereas the areas having mild climate conditions support pasture and cultural activities. Next is topography. Yes, dear children, the topography means the natural features of a land, especially the shape of the surface. So, well-drained plains region provides suitable conditions for agriculture activities and pasture. Such type of land use pattern attract a huge number of people. Next is type of soil. It's an important factor that affects the land use pattern. An adequate and well-planned land use pattern can be seen in the areas having fertile soil. Areas like cold and hot deserts have infertile soil. Therefore, these are free from the proper land use. Next is availability of water. As you all know, all the living organisms and non-living organisms, they need the water. Water is essential for a well-developed and planned land use pattern. All types of forest, crops, pasture, etc. need plenty of water to survive. Water is a basic need for all living beings. Thus, its availability is essential for both the settlements and the land use pattern. Next, we'll study about the minerals. Minerals deposit also influence the land pattern of a place. For example, a region having mineral deposits are used for the mining purposes, such as Kolar gold mine. Huge industries can be set up in the vicinity. The areas rich in mineral deposit are more suitable for the industrial growth. Next comes the last factor, that is technology and human resources. Technology and human resources are the two sides of a coin. Human resources use technology to convert the raw natural resources into valuable products that fulfill the requirement of the people. Human resources along with the technology are necessary for a successful land use pattern. So here we end up the factors that affect the land use pattern. Next we will study about the usefulness of the land resources. So how they are important to us? Land resources carry great significance in our lives. Some of them are discussed under. Land resources are rich resource of timber and other products such as gum, resin, medicinal herbs, etc. These are the storehouse of mineral deposits. They provide rich farming grounds. Land resources are also used as the places of tourist destination. They provide land both for the personal and professional use. Land resources provide lofty mountains, high hill, plateau, plain, river, pond, etc. Now let's start with the degradation of the land. Degradation of land refers to the decline in the productivity of cultivated and forest land. The changes in the characteristic and quality of soil that adversely affect its fertility is also termed as the land degradation. It is hard to separate soil and land from each other. It is estimated that 40% of the world's agricultural land is seriously degraded. Man himself and his activities are prime cause of land degradation. People are blindly exploiting land resources by building of houses, commercial areas and complexes in the cities, whereas in the rural areas, agricultural land is growing day by day. In process of claiming more and more land for his use and optimizing present and land under cultivation, man destroying his prime resources. Deforestation, overgrazing, development of transport, movement of the people and cattle result in reduced growth of the vegetation. It decreases the flora and fauna diversity, soil depletion and land degradation. Modern agriculture practices such as excessive use of fertilizers and pesticides, monoculture of certain crops, for example cotton and sugarcane, degrades the quality and fertility of the soil. Along with this, contamination of soil from chemical fertilizers, factory runoff, garbage dump and mining are a few other causes of the land degradation which pollute water bodies and soil both. These activities result to the degradation of the land, landslide, soil, erosion and desertification. To control the degradation of land resources, their conservation is essential. So let's study about the conservation of the land resources. The conservation of land resources refer to the careful use of proper management of these resources so that they may continue to be in use. The conservation of land resources is essential to save them for the next generation. Even the survival of the human being depends upon the availability of these resources. So, the following measures can be adopted to conserve the land resources. Those are, degradation rate of land should be exchequered. More and more trees should be grown. Land should be cleaned for the main use. Overgrazing should be controlled. Use of chemical pesticides and fertilizers should be regulated. Use of biofertilizers should be encouraged. Setting up of processing and filtering units in large industries to treat and segregate the toxic, non-toxic and organic waste before dumping them into the ground or water bodies. Using the land according to the land use capability. Covering the fallow land and landfills with the dry leaves and other organic waste. So in this way we can conserve the land resources. I hope children you have understood about the land resources, its degradation and conservation. So let us study about the soils in the next video. Thank you everyone. Have a great day ahead.